seems to me, just looking at it too, it's harder and harder to simply be the one place where all the big guests want to go. And that was what Johnny Carson had.
Totally. And Johnny was so much the center of show business that people wanted to be on his show.
If you wanted to be known as a comedian, you had to get on the Tonight
Show.
And Dave will tell you that.
Absolutely. But not anymore, because guests are less and less important on the shows. There's a bunch of guests you can get, and they've all been on Jimmy the first week, I think.
Right.
That'll make a difference. But after that, it's about the guy. It's always about the guy behind the desk. It really is about the guy behind the desk.
Because he's there or she's
there. He's there every night. And that person connects with you and they get to know. As Lorne Michaels said to me, you'll never, ever be more exposed than on this show. Because every night you're talking to the audience, you're conversing with them.
Do you buy the idea that if you are not a likable person, you can't be on television as long as David has, as long as Johnny was, as long as, you know, many of them have been?
I do. You have to be fundamentally likable.
Yeah.
I think some people are more or less likable than others.
Yes.
But I do, I mean, you know, Dave clearly had some people turned off because he can be tough and edgy, and he was rough on guests occasionally.
Right.
And Conan had the same issue.
Himself.
Conan was not right for a lot of Jay's audience. They felt he was too freaky or whatever. And Conan's wildly creative in a different way. They didn't get him. Conan did a very funny thing even before he went on. I don't know if you remember this, but he put on like a fake outfit and went and interviewed older people and showed clips from his show. Mm-hmm. And some of these older people say, I think this man belongs in a mental institution.
Well, he continues to do that too. But where is
Conan?
Yeah.
Conan still does extremely well with young people.
TNT.
They love him on TNT. He's on TNT, but he also has used the internet as well, very, very effectively. But it's a much smaller arena.
Morning television, which I know a little bit about.
Yes.
makes a lot of money.
Yes.
A lot of money.
Yes. Not so with late night anymore.
That's what I'm asking.
Not so. You know, in the old days, the Tonight Show was a money machine,
yeah.
$150 million a year or something. But now there's so many shows and their audiences have shrunk to such a point that a lot of them are on the thin edge of profitability. Kimmel didn't make money at 12 o'clock at all, ever. He never made money for ABC, ever. So it's become very difficult especially if you have a band and you have, you know, a costume department and prop department, which these shows all do.
The amazing figure in all of this is Lorne Michaels.
Yes, Lorne Michaels does now The Tonight Show, Late Night, Saturday Night Live. Three pillars of late night, all produced under his leadership.
And he's the guy who went to Jimmy Fallon, who wanted to go out to Hollywood and make movies.
Yes.
This is not what you should
do. No, he said up front, you're a late night host. That's what you really should do. You should think about that with your career. And who has had a better eye for talent than Lorne Michaels in the last 30 years? I mean, nobody.
Is there a book in this for you?
I'm waiting. I want a story to happen. There has to be conflict. So something has to blow up. Let's hope it does for my sake. Maybe not for theirs.